Next week, 9 of us, all Catholics, 2 of us priests, will take our religious bodies to a draft center in Catonsville, Maryland. There we shall remove the draft files, sprinkle them in the public street with homemade napalm, and set them afire. For which act we shall, beyond doubt, be placed behind bars, in consequence of our inability to live and die content in the plagued city, to say peace when there is no peace, to keep the poor poor, the homeless homeless, the thirsty and hungry, thirsty and hungry.
We ended up in prison, of course. Everyone thought we were fools, but there is a history in the Bible of acts such as ours. Acts at variance with good manners, illegal acts, acts that all good sense points to as being useless and ineffective. Catonsville was like a firebreak, lighting up the dark places of our hearts. And so we sat in custody, grinning like gargoyles. And that's where I was when Leonard Bernstein came to see me. He seemed tired and harassed, but gentle as a lamb. I think he just wanted to talk, to start a conversation. He wanted some help on a mass he was writing for the opening of the Kennedy Center.
I'm ready to throw it all away. Start over.
He was struggling to finish it.
A glorious solution must exist. I just pray I find it.
I didn't know if I could help, but I was willing to try, so I asked him, how do we translate into our lives the bombing of helpless civilians?
Like the work I've been writing all my life, my mass is about the fundamental struggle of our century, a crisis of faith.
How do we translate into the truth of our lives the 100,000 villages burned?
But the present crisis is not only a crisis of faith, it's a crisis of world revolution. This is a revolution essentially based on the right to eat.
The 1 million Vietnamese rounded up.
And we in the West, who insist on the right to eat at other people's expense, seem to be doing everything we know to prevent this revolution from taking place.
The 50,000 children napalmed.
Why is it we are always supporting the wrong side?
Surely it is better to burn draft cards than to burn children.
But how do we translate that into our lives, into our art?
Go before the people with the word of God. Translate the lies of the times.
That's why I'm writing this mass. Dear brothers, this is the gospel I preach, and in its service I have suffered hardship like a criminal, yea, even unto imprisonment. But there is no imprisoning the word of God. You can lock up the bold man. Go and lock up your bold men and hold.